color. It's all around us. We all see it, but we experience color differently. As trained printers and designers, we have a special eye when it comes to color, and we want to help you experience what we see. Welcome to Sticker Mountain. Today, we are talking about color theory and defining certain terms to explain how we do what we do. So, how do we see color? Marty, our big friendly Yeti, will be our guide on how we experience color. Color is the result of three key things: light, an object, and our eyes. Light produces wavelengths that bounce off an object and either absorb or reflect certain wavelengths back into our eyes, and we experience a particular color. Next, Marty is going to define a few key terms that help us describe color. By the end of this video, you will know what these six terms mean. Hue is the purest form of color, without any other tints or shades added to it. Hue can also be a color's name, such as red, blue, or green. Saturation is the intensity or the purity of a color. When it comes to printing, as we add more ink to the surface, the color becomes more and more saturated. As we add in more of our ink, the color becomes more intense. The scale from white to black is called lightness. In printing, we use this scale to adjust how bright or dark a color is. Color space is the original group of colors at your disposal. You might recognize different color spaces, such as RGB and CMYK. Our human eyes have their own color space. Fancy scientists call that the CIE color space. This graph shows the visible color spectrum and all the other color spaces that can fit inside, but not fill completely. At Sticker Mountain, we use the LAB color space. However, we will explain that in a separate video, so don't forget to check that out. A color gamut is the capability of a device to display certain color spaces, or the range of colors you can make with the original colors you have at your disposal. In this example, we see the range of colors in the RGB color space. Below that, we see the color range using the CMYK color space. They may look different, but that's because they use different methods to create color. RGB uses light to create color for digital displays, such as the one you're using right now to watch this video. CMYK uses ink to create color for printing images, such as the cool stickers and labels we make. When trying to match a color that lies outside of your color space, it is called out of gamut. This means that space cannot produce the color you want accurately. Finally, CMYK is a color model that creates white by subtracting color. CMYK stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and key, or black. The colors are laid together on a sheet of paper using tiny dots of ink. The larger the dot of ink, the more that color is represented, and the more those colors overlap, the darker they get. Since CMY alone doesn't make as dark of a black as needed, we add black ink to get the richness we desire. Now, take a look at this image. If you squint, notice how the inks start to blend together and create all sorts of different colors. Crazy, huh? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out our other videos on color. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to stay in the know of all of our other videos. See you next time, Yetis!